a bunch of goons led by a lumpen element named Pramod Muttalik get away scot-free with a clean chit from a court of law because the state cannot and does not want to prove the case against him. I want to go back to those pictures from 2009, that footage that we're running. Innocent young girls, 20, 21, 19 years old, some of them outside that amnesia pub in Mangalore. Because gundas of the Sri Ram Sene, led by Pramod Muttalik, decided this was not what Indian girls should be doing. This is not sanskari enough. Girls going to pubs, well, that's not part of Bharatiya sanskar. They were caught on tape. We have even encircled them as attacker one, number two, number three. We've identified who these people are. And yet, ladies and gentlemen, 9 years on, despite this video evidence, those gundas and their boss, Pramod Muttalik, have gotten away scot-free. And you know what the worst part is? After the verdict, Muttalik admitted openly on national television that yes, these are his boys. There's no remorse, there's no guilt, no apology. Instead, there's an open admission. And yet a court of law has set him free, has given him a clean chit. Face Off begins right now.
ये हमारे ही कार्यकर्ता थे लेकिन कोर्ट उसको अभी रिहा किया है ना वो पब कल्चर हमारी संस्कृति नहीं है ये पब कल्चर रोकने के लिए देश का कानून मुझे रिहा कर दिया है आपका कहने से कुछ नहीं होता आपके पास एविडेंस है तो आप कोर्ट जाइए
I'm going to play that interview, a brazen, defiant Muttalik. There you go. I'm going to play that full interview in just a couple of seconds. But here is how this gunda and his band of gundas, 30 of them, got away despite publicly attacking young women outside a pub in Mangalore. Number one, the prosecution, first under the BJP government, then under the Congress government, miserably failed to establish Muttalik or his band of gundas and their guilt, despite the video proof of assault. The statements of witnesses as well as victims were not recorded under Section 164 of the CRPC, which is before a magistrate and which is admissible in a trial. For some inexplicable reason, those statements were not recorded before a magistrate. There is clinching video proof, and yet the prosecution, which is appointed by the state, refused to verify it. And unless the prosecution verifies electronic evidence, whether it's audio or video, it cannot be admitted in a court of law as evidence. And number four, the complainant, the eyewitnesses, the victims, none of them came forward to depose because they did not have any kind of witness protection. They were scared of Pramod Muttalik and the Sri Ram Sene, this band of gundas in Mangaluru. So they refused to depose. Neither was the state or the prosecutor willing to give them any protection. And number five, the police did not present the victims, who, by the way, were also witnesses. They were the ones who were beaten. They were also witnesses to this horrific crime. The police, for some inexplicable reason, again, did not present them as witnesses in court. Stringent sections of the law, which could have been included, were again omitted for some inexplicable reason. And it is because of all of these reasons that Pramod Muttalik, this man, and his band of gundas who were caught on camera beating up young girls, managed to walk away scot-free. I caught up with Pramod Muttalik a short while back. He remains defiant, he remains brazen. He admitted to me on national television that yes, his boys were the ones who thrashed the girls outside the Amnesia pub in Mangaluru. And yet, no one seems to be able to do a damn thing to him. Let me play out Pramod Muttalik, exclusive here on CNN News 18.
अगर आप और आपके संगठन के लोग लोगों ने उनको नहीं मारा तो किसने मारा क्योंकि वीडियो पे तो बहुत साफ दिख रहा है कि किसी ने मारा है
कोर्ट पे सबमिट किया है कोर्ट उसको देखा है देखकर ही कल हमें रिहा किया है तो कोर्ट आप जो कह रहे हैं ना, कोर्ट को पूछना चाहिए।
कोर्ट ने ये नहीं कहा कहीं कि ये वीडियो झूठी है या गलत है या मॉर्फ्ड वीडियो है, ऐसा नहीं कहा ना कोर्ट ने? कोर्ट ने इसलिए एडमिसिबल नहीं कहा क्योंकि प्रोसिक्यूशन ने सर्टिफाई करने से मना कर दिया, इसलिए आप रिहा हो गए?
नहीं, देखिए ये तो हमारा काम नहीं है। सरकार जो केस हमारे ऊपर अरेस्ट करके केस डाला था, सरकार की जिम्मेदारी है, जो केस डाले थे उनका जिम्मेदारी है।
नहीं, वो तो इसलिए मैं आपसे पूछ रहा हूँ मुतालिक जी, क्या
वीडियो दिखाना था
आपके संगठन और सिद्धरामैया गवर्नमेंट के साथ? क्या कुछ सेटिंग है क्या आपका?
सिद्धरामैया सरकार ने मेरे ऊपर केस नहीं डाला है। उस समय बीजेपी सरकार था, येडियुरप्पा का सरकार था, तो येडियुरप्पा ने बीजेपी सरकार ने मेरे ऊपर केस कर दिया है। मैं तो उस समय वहाँ मौजूद नहीं था, उपस्थित नहीं था। मैं तीन दिन आउट ऑफ स्टेट महाराष्ट्र में
जो मार रहे थे ये कौन है ये लड़के, ये कौन है ये लोग?
नहीं, मैं वही कहता हूँ, ये हमारे ही कार्यकर्ता थे, लेकिन
आप मान रहे हैं कि आपके कार्यकर्ता थे?
अभी रिहा किया है ना,
आप मान रहे हैं कि आपके कार्यकर्ता थे? आप ये कह रहे हैं नेशनल टेलीविजन पे जो लोग मार रहे हैं, पीट रहे हैं, आपके कार्यकर्ता है?
हमारे कार्यकर्ता थे, वो जो लड़कियों को गलत तरह से मारपीट किया वो गलत है, इसके लिए मैं उसी समय माफी मांग चुका हूँ। वो तो गलत है, उसका उद्देश्य अलग था।
तो आप मान भी रहे हैं? नहीं, सुनिए,
हमारी संस्कृति नहीं है।
आप नेशनल टेलीविजन पे रोकने के लिए, मुतालिक जी, आप नेशनल टेलीविजन पे आप मान रहे हैं कि ये आपके लड़के थे, लेकिन वो रिहा हो गए सिर्फ टेक्निकलिटी पे। कोई किसी प्रकार का पनिशमेंट तो होना चाहिए, ये कानून को अपने हाथ में ले रहे हैं।
मुझे मैं कहता हूँ, आप तो शिक्षा तो हाईकोर्ट ही दे सकते हैं, हाईकोर्ट पे अपील कर सकता है, सरकार के हाथ में है। आपके साथ, आपके पास जो वीडियो है वो सिद्धरामैया को भेजिए। रेणुका चौधरी महिला अध्यक्ष थे, तो वो उसने एक टीम, महिला टीम ने यहाँ कर्नाटक में भेज दिया, तो निर्मला वेंकटेश के नेतृत्व में महिला टीम आकर यहाँ इंक्वायरी किया, तो उन्होंने एक रिपोर्ट दिया है। सुनिए, आप कहे, आपका जो सुनना नहीं, मैं यहाँ हूँ, मैं जो सच है वो कह रहा हूँ, वो रिकॉर्ड है वो कह रहा हूँ,
सुनना पड़ेगा। अगर आप ये समझते हैं कि आप कानून से, आप कानून के बाहर है, आप समझते हैं कि आप कानून से बड़ा है, तो मैं सुनाऊंगा आपको।
रिपोर्ट दिया है,
मैं पत्रकार हूँ, मैं पूछूंगा आपसे सवाल।
सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट को एक रिपोर्ट दिया है,
आज अदालत ने आपको बरी कर दी सिर्फ टेक्निकलिटी पे, तो मैं पूछूंगा सवाल आपसे। वहाँ आप नेशनल टेलीविजन पे आकर मानते हैं कि आपके लड़के ने मारे हैं, पीटे हैं लड़कियों को, तो मैं क्या चुपचाप रहूं? मैं चुप रहा हूँ,
मैं कहता हूँ वही वो
मिस्टर मुतालिक
ना,
मिस्टर मुतालिक
के बारे में आप, मिस्टर मुतालिक,
इफ द कोर्ट हैज एक्विटेड यू एंड 30 ऑफ योर गून्स ऑन अ टेक्निकलिटी, देन आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू कीप क्वाइट। मैं चुपचाप नहीं रहूंगा, मैं पूछूंगा, और जब तक इंसाफ नहीं मिले वो मैंगलोर के लड़कियों के लिए, तब तक मैं पूछूंगा।
गुण कहने के लिए, आपका सर्टिफिकेट लेने के लिए मैं नहीं है बेटा हूं, हमारे कोर्ट ने, न्यायालय ने न्याय दिया है, सो वही सर्टिफिकेट आज समाज में लोगों ने मुझे,
इसके बाद कांग्रेस
दे रहे हैं,
इसके बाद सुप्रीम कोर्ट,
आपका सर्टिफिकेट नहीं चाहिए मुझे गुण कहने के लिए। आप कौन होते हो?
इंसाफ,
आप कौन होते हो?
इंसाफ वहां पे भी लिया जा सकता है। मिस्टर मुतालिक, आई विल कॉल नॉट वंस नॉट ट्वाइस बट 1,000 times। इफ यू कम ऑन टीवी एंड एडमिट दैट योर बॉयज डिड दिस, देन दे नीड टू बी सेंट टू जेल। इफ यू गॉट एक्विटेड बिकॉज ऑफ अ टेक्निकलिटी ऑफ अ कोर्ट, देन योर प्लेस इज नॉट सिविलाइज्ड सोसाइटी, योर प्लेस इज जेल, एंड आई एम सॉरी।
And if you feel strongly about this, ladies and gentlemen, if young people are watching this, why should self-appointed guardians of our culture, Bharatiya Sanskar, people like Mutalik and his goons, decide whether you can go to a pub, whether you can drink beer, and whether you can go with a male partner of your choosing to a pub and drink beer? If you feel strongly, call us on 01204341895 and share your views. I'm looking forward to plenty of callers tonight. Mutalik has admitted on national television here on CNN News 18 that yes, his goons thrashed those girls outside the pub in Mangaluru. And yet, they all ganged up to let Mutalik and his goons walk away scot-free. How did this happen? How did Mutalik and co. get away? Joining us on our talking point tonight, Vivek Reddy, spokesperson of the BJP, Dr. Nagalakshmi, spokesperson of the Congress, Samia Saxena, lawyer, Sabah Azad, independent journalist and activist, somebody who faced a similar fate in Gurgaon some months ago, Brinda Adige, director of the Global Concerns Trust, will be joining us in a moment, and Sandeep Singh is RSS thinker and sympathizer. Let me start with you, Vivek Reddy. Here you have Pramod Mutalik openly admitting on national television that yes, his boys beat up those girls outside the pub in Mangaluru. Isn't this admissible in court? What more do you need to lock away this man and those 30 others who beat up those young girls? How long are we supposed to tolerate this, Vivek Reddy?
Well, Jacob, let me tell you one thing. Whatever Pramod Mutalik has done is absolutely wrong. First of all, no one can take the law into their own hands and start moral policy. Second, they cannot barge into the pub and try to manhandle people. Thirdly, this is a country where every individual has private freedom. And there is no way anybody can intrude into that space of private freedom. Given this, so far as the acquittal is concerned, as you said, it is on technical grounds. There is no substantive material on which the court has discarded the complicity of these offenders. But merely on technical issues, there has been an acquittal. So far as the last issue that you raised, whether this statement of Pramod Mutalik amounts to complicity in the case, well, at the stage when statements are made outside the court's jurisdiction or without any evidence before the court on that issue, statements made in television will not amount to...
No, no, but there is evidence. There is evidence. There is video evidence of these girls being beaten up outside the pub in Mangaluru. And yet,
well,
Dr. Nagalakshmi...
Dr. Nagalakshmi,
for some inexplicable reason... Dr. Nagalakshmi, your government, your state government refused to verify that video. As a result, that video could not be presented as admissible evidence in court. That's why today 30 goons and Pramod Mutalik are walking away scot-free. What message are we sending to our young women?
The result what has been come, I really feel hurt and, you know, dejectable because we never expected the result would be so. And it's not the Congress government which is not, which is favoring this type of result. To be very frank, at the time of this happened, what the circumstances what happened in 2009, the prima facie and the witnesses which were the police, I mean, under the BJP government in 2009, they could not record it, the witnesses and the prima facie properly in front of the judiciary.
No, but so ma'am, today, respectfully, what did your government do? What did your government do? Did you offer any witness protection? Did your state-appointed prosecutor say, we will verify this video? And what does it take to verify this video?
No. The law was under its course and the prosecution was going on.
65B.
And the only witness was the video. Okay. And
so
the,
why
the
didn't your state? Why didn't the prosecutor verify the video and submit this video as admissible evidence in court? We've had numerous cases of law in this country where video and audio, electronic evidence is admitted in court, provided it's verified by the prosecuting authorities.
See,
your prosecutor did not for some inexplicable reason. I don't know why.
No. Let me say that then the government, it took almost 1 year. Usually they say within 60 days you have to present it. But you know, once the entire India, all the women started a non-violent revolution against this Pramod Mutalik gunaism, which they did it on that time, the entire women organization started a non-violent revolution.
Vivek, ready to respond? Then I want to go to Brinda Adige and to Samia Saxena. Vivek, ready, quickly respond. The charge by the Congress spokesperson is you are in power, you diluted the case, you offered no witness protection, and in a year, you did nothing. You were in power from 2009 to 2013, you did nothing, you diluted the case. Jacob, let him respond, let him respond, let him respond.
And all the victims, were under fear.
Let him respond, yeah.
Nagalakshmi, madam, serious flaws in the manner in which the trial is conducted and witness protection. These issues arise during trial, and trial has taken place during the past 4.5 years. Let me tell you a second issue on which you have completely defaulted, betrayed the trust that is vested on you during prosecution. You are supposed to take a certification for the video evidence. The certification is to be taken under Section 65B, and this certification has to be available at the time when the video record is marked as evidence during trial. Unfortunately, it is very sad that you, despite the past 4.5 years you had during your time to rectify, to take it to a correct course of action and to give witness protection, you have failed on
both. No, I'm sorry. Again, we are reducing this to a BJP Congress binary. I don't care about BJP and Congress. What I care about is the millions of young girls who are watching. No, one second. I'm sorry. I'm going to stop. I'm going to stop Vivek Reddy and Dr. Nagalakshmi. I want young girls who are watching this program. Sabha is a young woman who met with a similar fate a few months ago. Sabha, as you watch this, as you read this news story breaking on Twitter and on television this morning, I want to ask you, Sabha, what is the message that you got as a young woman in this country and a victim who had to face a similar fate just a few months ago? That gundas will decide what is Bharatiya Sanskar? They will decide whether young women can go to pubs, whether they can drink beer, and whether they can be accompanied by a male companion? And they will get scot-free. They will beat up these girls and they will go scot-free. Sabha.
And see, like, it's not just this one video. This has been happening for years on end. And that's, in fact, this is the reason why so many women do not even report assault or report sexual harassment in the first place. Because what happened in court with all these 30 men being acquitted, it's part of a larger structural and institutional problem where the very mechanisms that were set up to help us, these mechanisms which have these lofty promises of ensuring justice, these very mechanisms let us down at every step of the way, be it from the police to what happened in court. And this the fact that you have this video, this is so brazen. These are 30 men, and obviously they're supported by the state, they're supported by the people in power.
Absolutely.
They're supported by an ideology that supports them. The government supports them. The government which espouses an ideology of Hindutva supports them. Even when I was assaulted, I wrote a Facebook post, and people from the local Gurgaon RSS said, yes, you deserve to be treated that way. Why were you out at night? Why were you having alcohol?
No, Brinda, this is the convenient, you know, bashing exercise. Bash the victim and allow the gundas to scot-free. Today, Shobha Karanlaje, member of parliament, no less, from the BJP, says, oh, it's because the girls should have taken greater care. They should have been more protective of themselves. What the hell does she mean by that? Brinda Adige, I want to know. Shame the victim, allow the gundas to walk away scot-free.
Continuously we see any government, whether it is BJP or it is Congress, unwilling to take any kind of responsibility and be accountable for the state of affairs. And like the other panelists pointed out, these fringe elements get emboldened because they are getting some tacit support from these political parties. And the patriarchal mindset continues to appropriate the blame, the responsibility to be safe, to be protected on the woman. Nothing on the system. These systems, these mechanisms, these structures are being paid. Their upkeep is by the voter and the citizen paying the tax. So why are they not going forward to extend that protection and safety? Making excuses over here. What more evidence do they want? Emboldening people like the Ram Saini and Mutalik. Look at him raging over there, saying that he's going to now take action. He's going to take revenge.
He is paying. He cocks a snook at the legal system. He cocks a snook at the innocent victims who were beaton up. He says, mere ladkon ne kiya hai, Sandeep Singh. And here we are, civilized country, 21st century India, talking about women's rights and gender justice, not being able to lock away a gunda and his band of gundas, who in broad daylight, by the way, let me remind our viewers, in broad daylight, beats up young women. Sandeep Singh.
Yep, Jacob, I look at it in a slightly bigger context. I see it as a preparation for the elections. Few days back, Sonia Gandhi said that, you know, they're trying to make it as a soft Hindutva party. And that is what Siddaramaiah is also trying to do. And you see, it will be played like that in coming months. No. And slowly you will take this ground to release more goons. It will be again played a minority card.
No.
So what you are seeing is that it's a pure political game.
Come on,
to them it doesn't matter if few girls were beaten
up. Cards,
these were the same people.
No.
You have Congress ruled for 4 years. They can't go and blame BJP that the prosecution was weak. If it was so weak,
that's an inexcusable defense, Dr. Nagalakshmi. Tonight, you cannot turn around and say that BJP was responsible.
No,
you've been in power 4.5 years.
Next two months,
there's elections.
Please,
aren't you complicit in the walking away of these gundas?
No.
Please tell me. Please tell our viewers. Please tell the young women who are watching the broadcast.
Our reaction is a...
Please tell us.
Is ample proof that what I'm saying is the truth.
I'm not telling. See, what the person was telling, that now the Congress government is releasing the goons next and minority. See, let's not get all this into it. See, the Mangalore, which is a vibrant city where this attack took place, this Mutalik and his goons, who are called Sri Rama Sene, once this attack was happened, it inspired many more like this to happen in the last
What did your government do? You are in power for the last 2 years. What were you doing?
Today. See, today
and if you cannot do in spite of being in power for 4.5 years, better not ask for
exclusively
votes.
Exclusively, which is made for women.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Your entire defense has crashed tonight. Your entire defense has crashed tonight. I refuse to believe that the state could not have got the prosecutor to verify this video. Soumya Saxena, 1 second. Soumya Saxena is a lawyer. Soumya, you tell me. No, one second. Sandeep, 1 second. Let me ask the lawyer on the panel. Soumya, you're a lawyer. Can video and audio evidence be admissible
Zakka,
in a court of law?
I mean,
have
yeah,
there
I
been
just,
instances no, where electronic
historian.
Evidence
I just want
has
to,
been
I just
admitted.
Want to step in here.
Yeah. Yeah, tell me.
Look, first of all, I want to step away from how they're politicizing the discussion, because this is really about something else, and I'm not interested in this blame game about who's responsible for it, because we as a society also have to take some responsibility, because we are the ones who are electing the governments that we are faced with. Now, the first thing is that, of course, it's admissible, provided it's been verified. It is not even so much a function. I mean, this man is brazen enough. He has the audacity to actually come on national television and claim that this has happened. And we are still unable to convict him because we cannot provide adequate witness protection. If this does not phase out our faith in the legal system, if this does not sort of make us question the due process of law that we are supposed to have faith in as law-abiding citizens, then I don't know what will.
It's unbelievable.
Ideally, Zakka, this is something that should outrage us as much as the Nirbhaya case. You realize, just look at the premise of what is happening. The premise is that these are men who wanted to teach these women a lesson about Indian culture. What were the rapists of Nirbhaya doing? Exactly that. Whether it's a drunken man raping a woman in a bus, whether it's a bunch of goons hitting women because they don't think they adequately represent or understand Indian culture, the premise is exactly the same, that these people think they're entitled
who are these
to
people?
Teach women through violence
and may I
what
add,
Indian culture
who
should
are
look
these
like
men?
Or what ideal conserve.
Who
this,
are these
I don't know,
men
this self-appointed,
to decide?
How can we
what
allow?
What is Indian culture, what is Bharatiya Sanskar, and what is not?
We've allowed Hinduism to be appropriated. We've allowed Indian culture, we've allowed Sanskar, we've allowed Hinduism in a lot of ways to be appropriated by these self-appointed goons of sort who dictate to us what ideal behavior should be like.
I want to go to callers. I want to go to callers. Let the people of India speak tonight. Let every outraged Indian speak tonight. Let every outraged young woman speak tonight. Because here you have a situation in this country, ladies and gentlemen, And we had a story going into the 8 o'clock show where Saudi Arabia, which is not exactly the beacon light for women's justice and gender equality, is giving women the right to drive. Tomorrow a day will come when Mutalik and gang will say, oh, women can't drive because it's not part of Bharatiya Sanskar, it's not part of Indian culture. So if you feel outraged, if you're a young woman, call us. 01204341895. We have our first caller. Our first caller tonight is calling from Shillong, Mr. Dipendu. Is that right? Dipendu from Shillong. All right. Good evening to you,
hello,
Mr. Dipendu.
Hello, Zakka.
Yeah. Go ahead, sir. Go ahead. Good
hello,
evening.
Zakka.
Good evening. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes. Yes. I can hear you. Go ahead.
Good evening.
Yes.
Good evening.
Yeah.
What I was saying is that it is amply clear that the state has failed, the administrative machinery has failed, the judiciary also has failed.
Yes.
What I can understand from the debate is that...
Yeah, yes, go on. I can hear you. Go on.
So, this is a call to the women folk of Bangalore.
Yes. Yes.
This is a call to the Bangaloreans.
Mr. Dipendu, I think...
Come out.
Yeah, I think your television set is on. If you can reduce the volume there, and then we can hear you in one go.
To come out in strength and strength and pull this chap out of his house.
Okay.
And see how he feels when he's treated in the same fashion.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. There was, by the way, a women-run campaign called the Pink Chaddi campaign in the immediate aftermath of what happened in Mangaluru. Women across the country came and participated in that campaign. And despite that campaign, despite this video evidence, these men have walked away scot-free. I want to point out, and I want to bring in our others back into the debate. In September of 2010, a Muslim girl in Kerala receives a death threat for not wearing a burqa. In August of 2014, UP Panchayat bans jeans and mobile phones for girls. In February of 2016, a fatwa is issued in Bareilly because Muslims are wearing a necktie. In January of last year, Dangal actress Zaira Wasim is trolled after the Jammu and Kashmir chief minister calls her a role model. In July of 2017, Irfan Pathan is trolled for tweeting un-Islamic pictures of his wife wearing nail polish. In July 2017, Mohammed Kaif is trolled for committing the sin of playing chess. Mohammed Shami is trolled for tweeting his wife's picture without a hijab. My point is, how long are we going to treat this, Sabha? How long are we going to allow Twitter trolls and promote mutaliks of the world to decide what a woman can and cannot do? Where she can go, what she can wear, who she can be with.
But, I mean, this has been happening since time immemorial. You look at the fact that, look at how when the BJP has come to power, they've created this bogeyman of love jihad. Just because a non-Muslim woman is choosing to date or marry somebody of another religion out of her own choice, this is how the custom of religion as well as patriarchy come together. It's all about how dominant segments of a certain religion want to control women's bodies. What Pramod Muthalik did in 2009, what these 30 goons did, it is all about them, their ideology wanting to control women's bodies and also wanting to exert their religious patriarchal mindset onto others. I mean, this has been happening since time immemorial and this needs to stop. And
no, it needs
every
to stop.
Time a woman...
And it needs to stop now. Because God knows, like I said, tomorrow, the mutaliks of the world will say women can't drive. So let's not drive. Today they're saying Priya Prakash Warrior can't wink. Tomorrow they're saying you can't go to a pub. The day after they'll say you can't accompany, a man has to accompany you every time you come to the street. Much like Saudi Arabia. We've got more callers.
We have a problem with an adult woman, Hadiya, marrying a man
exactly.
of choice. I mean,
Hadiya chooses to marry who she wants to marry. She has to go all the way to the Supreme Court to get justice.
Exactly.
Captain Jagpal is joining us on the phone line now from Rohtak.
Well, Zakka, let
Captain
me tell
Jagpal.
You one thing.
Captain Jagpal is on the phone
Zakka,
line. Yeah, I'm coming
in.
To you, Mr. Reddy. Captain Jagpal.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening, Captain Saab. Good evening.
It is a great honor to be on your channel.
Yes, sir. Please.
You can imagine the arrogance of this man when he's speaking to Zakka of CNN. The way he has behaved, the arrogance he has shown. Do you think a common man can take him on? It requires your help and it requires a campaign. Now coming first and first, these people, these are not fringe elements. It is a part of a hidden agenda And if I say Kaka in the mind of Kaka Atasri, it says, अंतर पट में देखिए छुपा हुआ है खोट अगर आपने सच देखना है तो देखो इन गुंडों की सवाल सब समाज में चित पर चोट दे आर दे यू कांट वी कांट लेट देम गो अवे दे दिस इज अ वेल ऑयल्ड मशीनरी दे एम इज टू स्केयर एवरी हिंदू एवरी वन टू वोट अकॉर्डिंग टू देम एंड द गवर्नमेंट द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट द होम मिनिस्टर दे हैव टू पुट देम अंडर एमएसए Otherwise, these girls, they should be armed with the weapons, they should put on chastity belt, have the chili spray, and in self-defense, shoot these bastards.
All right, I'm going to leave it at that. I apologize on behalf of the caller for the strong language. But I want to thank Captain Jagpal. Vivek Reddy, the sentiment with which today young women are watching this broadcast, what message are we sending, sir? What message are we sending? That young women in this country cannot go to a pub.
Let me tell you.
They cannot drink beer. They cannot have a male companion.
Zakka, let me tell
you
one thing. Yes. Let me tell you one thing. Let us set the political record straight. Whatever Jaspal said and whatever Sabha said. I needed to rejoin on that and, what I intend to say is what the actual reality as to what has happened. Let us not forget one thing. Sabha is trying to frame it as BJP. And it was most unfortunate. I am so sorry. This entire episode has been tracked by the BJP government and Pramod Muthalik has been arrayed as the first accused under the BJP government. Secondly, it was the BJP government that banned Pramod Muthalik from entering Mangalore after this incident. So don't ever try to say, I am sorry why Sabha is looking at it with certain, myopic eyes or with certain lensed eyes. That is not the approach to such a problem. It is BJP that has come down heavily against this moral policing in Karnataka. And the same
question. Mr. Reddy, simple question. Did Pramod Muthalik not join your party for a brief bit in Karnataka?
Yeah, he had joined the party and He joined for five hours.
And the central BJP directed, suspended his and expelled him in 5 hours. This was the fastest joining and the fastest expulsion.
No, but how come he didn't join any other party?
We did not want to associate
How come he did not join the left parties? How come he did not join the JDS? How come he did not join the Congress? How come he decided to join your party?
We don't know. You should go and ask him. No. But in any case, he is not part of our party. And we did not intend to associate with
Dr. Nagalakshmi and then Soumya also wants to come in.
How can you take a...
Dr. Nagalakshmi and then Soumya wants to come in.
For 5 hours, if a person joins a party for 5 hours...
Dr. Nagalakshmi.
And he is expelled immediately. Hello. Can you raise the blame? Come on,
Mr. Reddy's point is he was there only for 5 hours. He was expelled immediately, Dr. Nagalakshmi. How can you say BJP is complicit with Pramod Muthalik?
Pramod Muthalik was again joined to BJP after there was a complete against him joining the party. Then within 5 hours, they expelled him from outside the party. See, the BJP government, they did not charge sheet for complete 1 year, where then the records were tarnished and the girls who were victimized were under a state of fear. They were receiving threatening calls and still they could not come under prosecution because Muthalik and the goons, they kept under
Sir,
constantly
you had a
under
charge
fear
for
all
and
the
half
victims.
Years under your government. Sir, what did you do with
come
that?
On, no. First,
you had
see,
a charge sheet
first,
for four and a half
actually,
years. All you had to
see,
do is take the trial
see, come
forward
on, please,
and get the conviction. Don't
listen,
ever hide
listen,
behind
listen,
these lame excuses,
listen.
Madam. This is
no,
not the
no,
right
no,
approach.
No. I don't want
what
to give
an
excuse.
With an existing
yes, on,
charge sheet?
No, one second, is, one second, one second, one second, one second, one second.
Let
no, 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 one second, one second.
As a woman,
one second, one second, one second, one second. Today, no. Today, these fringe elements, Sriram Sene decides whether women can go to pubs. Karni Sena decides whether we can watch a movie. We've given the rule of law to these fringe elements to decide what we can watch. What
and
we can
this,
eat,
and,
what
and
we can drink, who he can, who we can be with.
You're not supposed to meet.
No, let me get more
who
callers before I go to Soumya Saxena. I'm coming to you, Soumya, one second. And Brinda Adigame. I got a caller. One second. I got a caller. Mr. Abhishek is calling us from Rajasthan. Mr. Abhishek.
Hi, Zakka.
Hi.
I'm calling from Ghaziabad, actually.
Oh, from Ghaziabad. Sorry. All right. Go ahead.
Yeah. So, Zakka, this incident, right, we have been seeing over the television, and I'm a common man with no affinity to any of the parties, right?
Yes, sir.
And this really disturbs us.
Yes, really disturbs us
that a fringe element like this can come on and threaten people. If my wife goes to a pub, that's my prerogative, right?
Absolutely.
If my sister or anyone goes, right? And they're talking about taking on China and others. With this, you can't take India to that level, which means you're saying this is Hindu culture, right? Now, take a case of Western countries, right? They are free. They go to pub and they do everything. Does that mean that the women are flashing everything in the public? That's not the case. The dignity is still there with everyone, right? And everyone knows what's right for them, what's wrong for them. You don't need a teacher to tell us that.
All right. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. Abhishek. Soumya, again, I keep coming back to this point. Here you have this man, no remorse, no guilt, nothing whatsoever.
Zakka, I just wanna...
Admits on TV. Let me just finish. Admits on TV that yes, it was his boys who did this. Can this be used by state in appeal when they go in appeal to the High Court?
This can definitely be used by states in appeal. And more importantly, I want to respond to your panelist who's taking a high ground on how Muthalliq wasn't a part of their party. Zakka, it's important for us to realize that we've had many such statements. This guy is not some isolated person who's saying it. We've had MLAs who say women should have 4 children or 10 children. I think it was Sakshi Maharaj. We've had people who tell us that, you know, women shouldn't eat this, women shouldn't have beer. The same politics over the kind of meats we eat. This appropriation of Hindu culture, I'm sorry, I'll have to say, is something that's very particular to this time. It's not something we've always had. To create this image of Hinduism and to create this image of Indian tradition, of this one kind of linear sort of a, you know, notion that everyone must subscribe to, is something that they've got to condemn. And as members who want to sort of dissociate themselves from this man and what he represents, they have to come out strongly in protection of all these women, in protection of all these minorities who have the right to choose whatever they eat. This, I mean, today it is, you know, sitting in a pub. Tomorrow it will be eating meat. Day after tomorrow it will be wearing this. The third day it will be who you marry. And
no,
these
let,
are new controversies. We've seen them since a very long time.
Sandeep
what
Singh,
were these governments
I'm just running.
Doing when the Karni Sena was...
I'm just running, even as we speak, comments made by different BJP netas from Kailash Vijayvargiya to Babalal Gaur to Manohar Parikar even, who recently said, oh, even girls are drinking beer in pubs in Goa. I mean, who decides this, sir? Will entitled men decide what a woman can and cannot do? And who decides whether this is part of Indian culture or not?
Already said that
no, whether this is part of Indian culture or not part of Indian culture. Some people have taken a contract to decide this is Indian culture, this is not Indian culture.
Hadia could go to Supreme Court to save her marriage. Ankit Saxena was beheaded in broad daylight in Delhi in just like ISIS style. So we have got this kind of people all across. I heard a lot of people abusing Hindu leaders, I don't know for what. But we have got this kind of fringe elements across. And we need a stricter rule and strict governance. Here we have got a governor or a Congress government which has failed to implement the law. And we are going around beating around the bush on everything on Hindutva, people appropriating Hinduism and whatnot, which has got nothing to do.
Including Muthalliq today. No, one second. Answer my question.
Let's stick to the fact that it is a failure of the state government.
Including Muthalliq today,
says
ये भारतीय संस्कार नहीं है. अरे आप कौन हो भैया? ये तय करने के लिए कि भारतीय संस्कार क्या है कि नहीं है.
They need to be punished. They need to be punished. We need a stronger state government. We need a stricter judiciary.
Now you're still deflecting the issue. You're still deflecting from the question that I asked you about Indian culture and whether some people have taken thekedari for Indian culture. Let me go to more callers. Captain Shahu Dange is calling us from Mumbai. Captain Saab, good evening to you.
Yes.
Go ahead, sir.
You see, I'm really surprised during last about, 5 years or so, after you see there is a change in the government, you see, lynching is taking place.
Yeah.
Then you see, Gaurakshaks, they are creating havoc. You see, then somebody kills Muslim guy on the road, take a video and then publish it. I mean, how these people are getting emboldened day by day. Now this man, he's an idiot of highest order. I'm sorry I'm using this language because I'm from the army. Now this fellow, what right does he have? Does he have any culture? Does he hate his daughter? Does he hate his wife? Does he hate his mother? What kind it shows that he has got a very dirty culture in his own house. Because, you see, he has to respect his mother, he has to respect his daughter, he has to respect everybody's mother and everybody's daughters and sisters. You see, he should have requested them. And who is he to say what should be eaten, what should be drank?
Absolutely.
If the girls want to enjoy after 19 years of age, why can't they go and have a glass of beer and enjoy? You see, today, girls are, you see, joining Indian Army, Indian Air Force. Recently, you see, there was, I passed out from OTA, and today, you see, the girl got the sword of honor. These girls are, you see, scaling the great heights because they get freedom, they get good culture, they get education. And now these people from nowhere, and they're getting emboldened because of the BJP government's support.
That is a fantastic point that you made, Captain Saab. And coming from one second. No, let me finish. No, Mr. Reddy, one second. You have to respect the views of the caller. Please.
This is not.
Respect the views of the caller. Let me just paraphrase and tell our viewers that Captain Dange is 100% right. Captain Dange is 100% right that today women of our country are flying fighter jets. They are passing out as pilots in the Indian Air Force. They are passing out as officers of the Indian Army. Tomorrow,
it is appreciable.
Some loony mutalik will say, women can't enroll in the army.
Absolutely, he cannot do it.
Ye mardon ka kaam hai.
Ye Bharatiya sanskar nahi hai.
Mr. Reddy, quiet. No, Mr. Reddy, you have to respect the views of a caller. And I agree 100% with Captain Dange.
Absolutely.
Some loony mutalik will say, women cannot enroll in the army. Women cannot become fighter pilots. Women cannot become officers of the Indian Army. Brinda Adige, is that what we are coming down to? The rule of the street? The rule of lumpens like mutalik?
I'm outraged that we could even think of something like this. Because some of our panelists are skirting the issue. How did this man get emboldened? Who is he? Who gave him the authority to decide and dictate how women should be? And what is Bharatiya Sanskari? And under what definition does his Bharatiya Sanskari permit him to go around pulling women, dragging them by their hair, beating them up? Who gave that permission to him? Who gave him that authority? Whoever it is, there is some support to him. This is unacceptable. We are citizens of a democracy and we have given ourselves our constitution. And this constitution is what will govern me and must protect me. The mutaliks of this country should be punished, should be penalized.
Sabha,
anybody giving tacit, direct support
Do you feel that the state, whether it is the state government in Karnataka, state governments in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, UP, wherever these incidents happen, Haryana, where you were, do you think it's because of the tacit support of the powers that be that people like Mutalik
obviously
are able to get away scot-free?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is the same man who also recently defended the prime accused in Gauri Lankesh's killing. He is enjoying all impunity because the people in power are giving him. Look at what happened with the BJP leader's son in Haryana who stopped Varnika Kundu. Have we forgotten Vikas Barala? Was that not tacit support of those in power? There is obvious support from those in power. I mean, that's why it's continuously happening.
Okay. We've got a final caller tonight. Final caller is again from Bengaluru.
So many incidents of Maulvis.
Final caller.
Maulvis issuing fatwas. What answer have you got for that? You're not answering that.
No, I condemn that. I condemn that. Priya Prakash Warrior, people said you can't wing. You said people said that the song is un-Islamic. I condemn that. I condemn that too. But please don't bring in this false equivalence.
Why are you condemning Zakka? She has to condemn.
No. She condemns it too. She condemns it too. Let me get in our final caller.
She didn't.
Our final caller. Mariam is calling us from Bengaluru. Our final caller tonight. Good evening to you, ma'am. Good evening, Mariam.
Hi, Zakka. I'm calling from Bangalore and I just have a question. For how long should people be telling women what they should be wearing, what they should be eating, what they should be driving, what time they should go home? Apparently, there's a time when it's unsafe for women to be out, and there's a time, and there are all these unwritten rules, and it all falls under this umbrella called Bharatiya Nari, and that's just and that's just absolute bullshit. And it's really sad that the judiciary, which is such a big influencer in the country, isn't able to protect one of India's women just from hooligans like Mutalik. And I think the Pink Chaddi campaign should be brought back. It's just bull.
Maybe it's time for Pink Chaddi campaign too. And I think the final caller, Mariam from Bengaluru, had a great point. I mean, are we today going to tell our girls, come back home by 9 o'clock, come back home by 10 o'clock? And by the way, for God's sake, this happened in broad daylight in Bangalore. Broad daylight, in the middle of the day. So if we can't protect our women on the streets, in public spaces, in the middle of the day, then how are we to protect them at night or any time? And who are we to protect them? They have every right to decide. Grown-up adult women have every right to decide what they want to eat, what they want to drink, what they want to wear, and who they want to be with. And let no government, no political party tell you otherwise. And I'm ending this by saying what I told Mutalik. The arm of the law is long in this country. There is still an adjudicatory process. This case has to go to the High Court. It has to go right up to the Supreme Court. And hopefully, the wheels of justice, as slowly as they may grind, they will eventually get justice for those young girls in Bengaluru. I'm going to leave it at that. Thank you very much to all our callers, to all our panelists. But like I said, it is a shame, it is an utter shame that it came down to this, that a bunch of girls were openly attacked, beaten, hit, abused, molested, and yet the people who did it are walking away scot-free, given a legal clean chit by a court of law in this country. I'm going to take a quick break. When we come back on the other side, Rex Tillerson, the Secretary of State, the equivalent of Foreign Minister, is fired by his boss, Donald Trump, with a tweet. The CIA Director, Mike Pompeo, will now be the new US Secretary of State. Details when we return. Welcome back. In an unprecedented move, U.S. President Donald Trump has fired his Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson, on Twitter and has replaced him with the CIA Director, Mike Pompeo. Tillerson, who is on an official visit to Nigeria, was unaware of the reason that led to his dismissal. After sacking him and putting out that tweet, Trump said that differences on Iran had led to the firing.
As far as Rex Tillerson is concerned, I very much appreciate his commitment and his service, and I wish him well. We got along actually quite well, but we disagreed on things. When you look at the Iran deal, I think it's terrible. I guess he thought it was okay. I wanted to either break it or do something, and he felt a little bit differently. So we were not really thinking the same.
All right. Tillerson also made some comments about this nerve gas attack that had happened in Russia, which could have been the final straw given Trump's love for the Russians. Quick break. On the other side, Bhupen will be here with Viewpoint. 9 CRPF Jawans have been martyred in a Naxal attack in Sukma in Chhattisgarh. The Naxals blew up the mine-protected vehicle using heavy explosives, and it triggered several IEDs. Details and a full debate right on the other side. Welcome back. 9 CRPF Jawans have been martyred in a Naxal attack in Chhattisgarh's Sukma area. After a blast that occurred when a team of CRPF's 212th Battalion was patrolling in a forest in Kistaram, over 100 to 150 Naxals targeted the CRPF camp. It happened at 8 a.m. this morning. The Naxals blew up the Jawans' mine-protected vehicle using heavy explosives. They also triggered several improvised explosive devices. Sources telling CNN News 18 that Hidma, the head of the Naxal People's Liberation Guerrilla Army's 1st Battalion, is suspected to be behind the IED attack.